Apparently he has a lot of real names.
No, that's John. I've known him since we were kids.
Were you aware that he was impersonating your brother?
Yes. I started getting telemarketing calls for Blake. It used to happen all the time. Blake had split up with his girlfriend, so he was living with me before he died. And at first I just brushed them off, thinking they didn't know about his death. But when the calls kept coming, I knew something was wrong.
Good afternoon. I'm Dr. Keyes. Chelsea. I can explain.
What the hell are you doing? This is sick. My brother is dead.
I know. I know. I saw that Blake died and I got this idea. And it got out of hand.
Got out of hand? Unbelievable. What, are you getting some kind of kick out of this?
No, I didn't want to hurt anyone. I just wanted to be Blake. Or I wanted his life.
No, you don't. You have no idea. Do you even know what happened to him?
Saw the obituary. I assumed that he got sick or was in some sort of accident.
He swallowed a bottle of pills. He was a frustrated, broken, manic depressive mess.
Why would he do that? He had everything.
Well, I guess everything wasn't enough for him.
I'm really, really sorry, Chelsea.
Yeah, just live your own life, John. And stop living my brother's, because you don't know anything about it.
Blake was one of those people who looked like he had a perfect life. Always the center of attention, but inside it was a different story, and John didn't know that.
You said you knew him since you were kids. How?
Well, John's mother was our live-in nanny. I was the youngest, and she and John lived in our guest house until I left for college.
All right, did John always idolize Blake?
I think it was more about the attention Blake got. John's mother was with us all day, so looking back, he was starved for that attention. John's entire childhood was like that. He was always on the outside looking in at all of us. And never his mother's priority.
Have you seen John since the clinic?
No, I checked back a couple days later. He was already gone.